This is Jarrod Horak for the RunawayHorse.com, and in this week's Kentucky Derby points race video, I'm going to take a look at the Rebel Stakes. But before I do that, let's recap the Derby races that I've done so far on the road to Derby 2021. And in these Derby prep videos, I've covered 22 races so far. My top choices have won 9 races. They finished second twice, and they finished third 5 times. Now, last week, I did not have a winner in the 2 races that I covered. I covered the Gotham Stakes. My top choice finished third there. And then in the other race that was run at Santa Anita Park, the San Felipe Stakes, I didn't pick Life is Good on top because I knew it was going to be a very low price, but he was very impressive for trainer Bob Baffert. Nice effort there. Now, the race that I did not cover in video format last week was the Tampa Bay Derby. And as I said when I was doing my other two videos, that they drew the Tampa Bay Derby late, so I wasn't able to do that one in video because I had an earlier start. I didn't have time to cover that one last week, but I did cover that one as part of my Santa Anita Park full card. Now, typically, I cover full cards from Santa Anita each day at therunawayhorse.com. Each day the Santa Anita runs, I do a full card, and then on weekends, and especially Saturdays, I cover a lot of stakes races around the country, and I covered multiple stakes races around the country last week, including the Tampa Bay Derby as part of that Santa Anita Big Cap Day full card. And in the Tampa Bay Derby, my top choice was Helium, and he did win that race at 15-1. So I had the 15-1 winner on my full card, but I just wasn't able to cover that one in video format. Sorry about that. I would have loved to have given out that nice 15-1 winner, but we have done well in these Derby videos. As I said, I've had 9 winners. And a couple weeks ago, I had the John Battaglia Memorial, Hush of a Storm. I had at 6-1, I had the Southwest Stakes winner, Essential Quality, and the Fountain of Youth winner, Greatest Honor. So I went 3-for-3 the week prior to last. And then last week, we did not have the winner. So let's see if we can bounce back this week and get a video winner for you. And we're going to cover the 11th race at Oaklawn Park on Saturday, March 13th, 2021, the Grade 2 Rebel Stakes. For 3-year-olds, the purse is $1 million. They're going to be traveling 1 1/16 on the main track. And we have a scheduled post time of 6:16 p.m. for this 11th race. And in this 8-horse field, number 1, Caddo River, is your 9-5 morning line favorite for trainer Brad Cox. Now, Brad Cox has been having a lot of success this year on the road to the Derby. In these points races, he has Essential Quality, your 2-year-old champion, who won the Southwest Stakes for him. He also has Mandaloon, and Mandaloon won the Risen Star Stakes at Fairgrounds. And then Caddo River is his 3rd Derby contender, and Caddo River won the Smarty Jones Stakes at Oaklawn Park earlier this year. And he went wire to wire, and he won by 10 lengths that day as my top choice. Now, in his start prior to that, he broke his maiden by more than 9 lengths. In his first 2 career starts at 7 furlongs, he finished 2nd both times, and he finished in front of Greatest Honor in both of those races, and Greatest Honor came back and he won the Holy Bull and Fountain of Youth Stakes at Gulfstream Park earlier this year. So Caddo River, with a lot of speed from the inside post, Florin Giroux is going to ride back. He's 2-for-2 with this one, and look for him to try to go wire to wire again. The 2, Big Lake, for trainer Steve Asmussen. He's 12-1 morning line. Ricardo Santana Jr. is going to ride. American Pharaoh is the sire of this one. And his first 2 career starts at 7 furlongs, he did muster a 3rd place finish in his career debut. Those 2 races were both when he was a 2-year-old. He returned this year and he ran 2 turns in both of those races that he has had this year. Both races were at 1 1/16 at Fairgrounds in January and February. He drew post 10 in both of those races. He rallied from 7th place to break his maiden on January 16th. And then February 13th, he stuck the pace from 3rd. He took over. He had a 6-length lead, and then he held on to win by a 1/2 length. This is his first stakes start, and he's facing some pretty salty company. The 3, Hozier, one of 2 entrants for trainer Bob Baffert, and Bob Baffert has had a lot of success in the Rebel Stakes over the years. Going back to 2010, Bob Baffert has saddled the winner of the Rebel Stakes 7 times since then. So he's had a lot of success in the Rebel. He has these Southern California shippers that are ready to go in this race, and we'll see how good Hozier is, because in his career debut, he was beaten 14 lengths by Concert Tour, his stablemate, and Concert Tour is in this race for Baffert as well. And Concert Tour is 2-1 in this race. Hozier is 12-1. But he did run much better 2nd time out at 1 1/16 when he stalked from 3rd place, and he won by a bit less than 2 lengths. He beat his stablemate Fenway and a John Sadler trainee, Star Sailor, that day. And both of those horses Fenway and Star Sailor came back in a recent maiden race at Santa Anita around two turns, and they finished 5th and 6th, so I'm not sure about the strength of the field that Hozier beat last time. The 4 Get Her Number for trainer Peter Miller. This one is 8-1 morning line, and he is a Grade 1 winner. He won the Grade 1 American Faro Stakes last year, last September at Santa Anita Park at 1/16, where he tracked the pace from 2nd. He won by 3/4 of a length over the late-running Rumbauer, and Spielberg was 3rd there for trainer Bob Baffert. So Get Her Number with switching surfaces that day. Probably will try to get into a forward position under Javier Castellano. The 5, Twilight Blue. This one has run 6 times overall with 2 wins, a 2nd and a 3rd. And he's only started around 2 turns 1 time, and that was in his last start. He stretched out, caught the mud at Oaklawn Park on February 11th. Entry-level allowance race from the inside post. He stuck the pace, and he won nicely by a half length. But he's going to have to run much better in this spot to compete with these much better horses. The 6, Keepmeinmind, he's 4-1 morning line. He's your third choice on the line, and he ran well in all 4 starts last year. His career debut, a race originally scheduled for the turf, moved to the main track at Churchill Downs, and he rallied to finish 2nd that day. And then as a maiden, he competed in 3 stakes races. And in his next 3 starts, the Grade 1 Breeders' Futurity, the Grade 1 Breeders' Cup Juvenile, and then the Kentucky Jockey Club Stakes, which he actually broke his maiden in the Kentucky Jockey Club Stakes, and in the Breeders' Cup Futurity and Juvenile, both at Keeneland at 1/16 last fall. Essential Quality won both of those races. Keepmeinmind was 2nd in the Breeders' Futurity and 3rd in the Breeders' Cup Juvenile, rallied from 14th place. And then, as I said, he broke his maiden in the Kentucky Jockey Club Stakes at Churchill Downs last time. He rallied from last, so he went last the first as the 2-1 favorite. That wasn't a strong race. Horses that have come back out of that race have not been running well. And also, Keepmeinmind was supposed to start his 3-year-old season in the Southwest Stakes, but that race was rescheduled 2 times, and then he was not able to run there. He missed some training time. He has a gap in his workouts from February 8th to February 26th. So then he missed some training time when Oaklawn had the bad weather, the freezing temperatures, the snow, and he just wasn't able to be ready for the Southwest Stakes, so they just waited for the Rebel Stakes. So now missing that time could cost him. He's also a big closer, and he's going to need some pace help. The 7 Concert Tour, he's 2-1 for trainer Bob Baffert. As I said, Baffert's seven wins in the Rebel Stakes, so he certainly has a lot of success in this race. Nadal won it for him last year. Concert Tour is going to be up on the pace, and he's 2-2. He looked excellent in his career debut at 6 furlongs as the even money favorite, battling on the pace, winning easily. Second time out, the Grade 2 San Vicente Stakes at 7 furlongs, tracked from 3rd, battled with his stablemate, Freedom Fighter, outfinished that one and won by a half length. Freedom Fighter was clearly 2nd best. He came back to run in the Gotham Stakes, a 1-turn mile last week at Aqueduct, and he ended up setting the pace and weakening to finish 4th. So Concert Tour is now going to try his hand around 2 turns, Street Sense the sire, Tap It the damn sire, and look for this one to be up on the pace under Joel Rosario. Finally, number 8, Superstock. He's run 6 times in his career, and he's finished in the top 3 in 5 of those 6. He has 1 career win, and his only bad race was on turf, and it was on yielding turf in his career debut. His other 5 starts on the main track, he was in the top 3 each time. He picked up some Derby points last year in the Grade 3 Iroquois, the first Derby points race where he finished 3rd. He was 3rd. He was 3rd also in the Breeders' Futurity, and Keepmeinmind was a length and a half in front of him, finishing 2nd that day. So he's going to need to make up some ground on that one, and he's going to have to stalk wide probably from this outside post. So I think the main 2 contenders in here certainly are the 2 favorites. I think Keepmeinmind could be a little short from a pace standpoint. He's going to need a lot of pace help as well. So I think Keepmeinmind could come up a little bit short in here, maybe hitting the board. I think this one comes down to number 1, Caddo River, and number 7, Concert Tour. They're your 2 favorites, and I would not be surprised if Concert Tour ended up being the favorite based on all of the success trainer Bob Baffert has had in this race since 2010. But I am going to go with number 1, Caddo River, as my top choice. He was my top choice in the Smarty Jones Stakes, and I'm going to stick with him. As I said, Brad Cox doing well this year on the road to the Derby. He's loaded with top contenders. This horse has speed and the rail. I think he's the speed of the speed in this race. And I think from that inside post, they have to go. Florin Giroux is just going to have to send him out. And if he breaks sharp and he gets that early lead and he's able to maybe get a little bit of separation on Concert Tour, maybe a length in front or something, I think Caddo River is going to be the one to catch and beat in the Rebel Stakes. So don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. And also go over to therunawayhorse.com if you're interested in my full card analysis from Santa Anita Park each day. And also on my New York page, my California page, bonus free stakes races each weekend. So don't forget to check those pages out. Finally, my Kentucky Derby 2021 page. I have Kentucky Derby and Kentucky Oaks blogs and videos posted there. So go over there and catch up on all the Derby action. And that will wrap up this week's video. I'll be back next week to look at some more Kentucky Derby points races. Hey everyone, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. For bonus free picks, Kentucky Derby blogs, and full card analysis from Santa Anita Park, head on over to therunawayhorse.com and check out my daily best bets blog at horseracingnation.com. Also, good luck at the races.